Like other pseudonymous apocalypse, these sibyllines contain evidence of being the work of a number of different authors. They are obviously a composite of Jewish and Christian elements. The citation from the Sibyl which appears in Josephus shows that the oldest portion of our present third book must have been current before the beginning of the Christian era. The verses of the Jewish Sibyl probably originated at Alexandria, and may possibly have incorporated some fragments of more ancient oracles once included in the Sibylline books which were kept at Rome. They presented such a fascinating form of pseudepigraphical composition that not a few other writers followed the successful example and put forth verses of various merit. And so it came to pass that after a few centuries the later Jewish and the early Christian literature abounded with poetic oracles purporting to be productions of the ancient Sibyls. Many independent compositions of this kind were accordingly in circulation sometime before the task was taken in hand of arranging the entire body of so-called Sibylline oracles into one connected and orderly series. This task was undertaken by the author of what is known as the anonymous preface, who combined the scattered oracles into 14 books.
The repetitions of language and sentiment now found in these different books indicated that already, before this larger task was attempted, other minor compilations had been made, and that the later compiler and editor left these smaller independent collections intact, not attempting to eliminate the repetitions, nor even to harmonize the conflicting statements. The first printed edition of the Greek text was brought out by Xistus Betuleius, Sixtus Birke, at Basel in 1545. A metrical Latin version of this by Sebastian Castalio appeared in 1546, and another edition of the Greek text, amended by the same scholar, in 1555. In 1599 Ioannis Opsopoeus, John Cock, published at Paris an edition of the Greek text, accompanied with the Latin version of Castalio, and with brief prolegomena and notes. But all these editions were superseded by that of Servetius Galleus, published at Amsterdam in 1687 and 89, in 2 quarto volumes. One volume contains the Greek text, with the Latin version and extensive annotations, the other consists of dissertations on the Sibylines and their oracles. This text and translation, accompanied with numerous notes taken largely from the work of Galleus, was republished at Venice in 1765, in the first volume of Gallandius' Collection of the Fathers.
The next important contribution to the Sibylines was the discovery in the Ambrosian Library at Milan, of the 14th book, which was published by Angelo Mai in 1817. The same distinguished prelate subsequently found in the Vatican Library at Rome 4 books, and published them in that city in 1828. The first to edit and publish the entire collection of 12 books was J. H. Friedlieb, whose single volume, issued at Leipzig in 1852, contains the entire Greek text, with a remarkably close metrical version in German, a valuable introduction, and a collection of various readings. A still more complete and critical edition is that of C. Alexander, whose first volume appeared at Paris in 1841, and contains the Greek text and a Latin version of the first 8 books, and extensive critical and exegetical notes. Two subsequent volumes, Paris, 1853 and 1856, supplied the remaining books, 7 excursas, and a bibliography of the Sibylline literature. A new edition, condensing the material of his previous dissertations and presenting all in a single volume, appeared at Paris in 1869.